Hey everyone, today I'm going to share with you a quick tip on how to have a better control of the drone camera in Flight Sim 2020. Before I get to that though, I'd love to hear from you to know what type of content you're looking for from the channel. If you have any type of questions or videos that you'd like to see covered, please make sure to put them in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. Alright, let's get to this week's tip. You probably already know about the drone camera that's available in the game. You can get to it from here and just press on the showcase button. What I recently found out when I was reading through the Flight Sim official forums is that you can actually use an Xbox controller to control the drone. I've got my Xbox controller right here, and all I did was use a regular USB cable and plugged it into my computer. And once I loaded up the game, I went into the key bindings in the controls to make sure that everything was bound correctly. The game developers clearly thought about this ahead of time, because by default, all the bindings are what you would expect them to be for the typical Xbox game. In fact, I didn't have to touch any of the key bindings at all. As a neat bonus, on top of the drone camera, the Slew Mode keys also get mapped to the exact same bindings as the drone camera. That makes it a lot more natural to move the plane around with the joystick rather than having to use the keyboard. By default though, it also binds a bunch of flight control surfaces to the Xbox controller. You can see here it's bound some settings to the primary control, secondary control, and the trimming surfaces. In my configuration, I cleared all of these mappings because I didn't want to accidentally control the airplane from the Xbox controller. I want to use my flight stick only for controlling the airplane, and I want to use the Xbox controller only for controlling the drone or the Slew Mode. Clearing those bindings is pretty easy. All you have to do is click on one and then click clear current input and just press the validate button. Once you've unmapped all of those keys, you just press apply and save, and then head back into the game. The controls are going to feel familiar for anyone that's used to playing with an Xbox controller. So the left stick is what you would use to go from side to side and front to back. The right stick is what you would use to change your camera angle, whether you want to look right or left or up or down. You'd use the triggers to change your altitude either up or down. And you can use the bumpers to change your angle and even flip it completely upside down if you want to get a really funky screenshot. I feel like the Xbox controller really gives you that extra control that you don't quite have when you're using the joystick. You can even do some cinematic stuff, like having the plane fly by you and then follow it as it flies away. The Slew Mode keys are very similar, so if I press Y to get into Slew Mode, at that point, again, the left joystick is what I'm going to use to move the plane around, and the right stick is what I will use to control the roll and the pitch. Just like with the drone camera, the triggers are what you'd use to change your altitude. And then once you've got your plane in position, you can just press the Y button again, and you're back in the flight mode. If you got some value out of this video, please make sure to hit the like button, and I'll see you next time.